studies show that 5 years out of college, there's already a difference in pay between men and women. Even if you have the same major, the same GPA, the same career trajectory, that quickly, nothing but pay discrimination can explain the gap. And that's something that should be very real for women on this campus, because over the course of our career, it costs every woman, on average, $413,000 missing from your pocketbook, from your wallet, because of pay discrimination. You know, I know here at Cornell there are a lot of folks who are really engaged on issues of social justice, but I think Cornell student population maybe has a tendency to think the political process is completely lost. There's no way to affect change through that process. We have to work entirely outside of the system and are disconnecting from the electoral process. And while there may be something to that critique, certainly, I really want to encourage students not to abandon the hope and to get out and work for candidates they believe in. I think women's health care and issues that women care about and that other marginalized groups care about should be on the agenda during every election. I would hope that it's normally not about the ways in which someone has tried to turn back our rights, but is instead about advancing and what we're going to do to move forward and become a more equitable country. But they should always be part of the discussion. They're not side issues, they're not unimportant. I don't think that I am in particular entitled to contraception or that we're entitled to contraception. I think the case is much more about what kind of a society do we want to live in. If we think about what contraception means for people, it's not only about having access to the health care that you need and the human rights aspects of having access to health care, but it's also about what being able to control your own reproduction does for women specifically, but for men as well. It allows us to pursue the educational opportunities that we hope for and to have the careers and the career trajectory that we dream of. The rates of representation in our legislatures are shameful. We have 17% women in Congress. The numbers for women of color are even lower. The number of representatives who are gay is a handful. And we have to do better, and it's on young people and on this generation to be the group that does better. So I hope to do what I can to inspire folks to take that on and to rise to that challenge.